I'm Nick Harcourt, and it's Transmissions from the World Art Stage. Our guest is fantastic Negrito. How you doing, man?
I'm doing well. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you very much for being here and for performing for us. But now, are you ready for 21 questions?
Let's try it.
It's quick fire.
It's okay.
Yeah. What is your first musical memory?
My first musical memory was hearing Louis Armstrong. My dad was playing Louis Armstrong, and I was like, I think it was St. Louis Blues, and I'm like, man, what is that? It just immediately affected me.
What was it about it?
It's just the sound of Louis Armstrong. I never heard it, and once I heard it, I made an immediate connection to the music, and I was really interested and asked my dad, and I'd go around humming it, and try to go to school and tell the kids about it in elementary school, and they just looked at me with a blank stare.
When did you know you wanted to do music?
Oh, I started very late, probably 19. Yeah, I wasn't playing music at all as a child.
What was your first instrument?
I started banging around on that piano that I was playing earlier.
Uh-huh. Well, not that one.
Yeah, it is that one. Yeah, probably piano. I started banging around on that, and, I went on to other instruments and played pretty well up until the time I had an accident, which took my hand, basically. And then I just kind of got into the guitar. As soon as I came up with Fantastic Negrito, I thought, you know what, I better play the guitar.
Do you remember the first song you played?
I just made songs up always. I never played any songs.
Right.
I would just go and start teaching myself stuff.
So you were never interested in playing somebody else's music?
Not really.
Straight away, you were just...
Yeah, straight right away. Yeah. You know, I've learned some things, but... I was really interested in this narrative in my head.
Who's your favorite artist who does what you do, living or dead?
It'd have to be Robert Johnson. I just feel like he was just complete as a player, as a songwriter, as a singer. He's amazing.
Do you remember the first time you heard Robert Johnson?
Yeah, I hated it.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was like old relatives in the South and they were playing it and I hated it. I didn't get it. It took me a long time to get it.
I was gonna say, when did that turn around for you?
I would say maybe 5 years ago, recently, I think that it happened where I think I lived enough, you know, and I'd failed enough and, you know, accomplished enough. And I think
you really had to be able to feel the blues.
You had to feel what he was feeling. There's something very, powerful about that man. And, you gotta be ready for it.
Sounds like you've done a few things already along the journey of life, but if you didn't do this, what would or could you do?
I used to grow a lot of weed in Oakland. I'm pretty good at that, so maybe I'd be a farmer, kind of like that.
I heard there's money in that these days.
Not as much as there was 10 years ago. But I'd like farming, organic farmer, polygamist, like something like that. That kind of suits me.
I was going to ask you what your idea of happiness is, but I think you might have just told me.
Happiness, that's a good one. My idea, should I answer that one?
Yeah, what's your idea?
My idea of happiness?
Happiness
is actually gratitude, you know what I mean? Being really thankful. And I think it came again from a near-death experience and spending 3 weeks in a coma and losing everything. That gratitude, I figured out, was happiness. As long as you wake up and you make this movement and you're happy for that movement. It was taken from me once, so.
I was going to say, can you tell me a little bit about that?
The peak of my narcissism. Mm-hmm. I'm hanging out in Hollywood. I have a big deal on Interscope. And, you know, I was doing things I shouldn't have been doing. And I was coming down Highland. It was Thanksgiving. And I woke up 3 weeks later with a very nice beard, though. But that's what happened. Basically, a car hit me and flipped me over about 4 times. And I broke everything, the arms and my... See my mangled hand, playing hand, which I can barely move in this one, but that's what happened. The best thing that ever happened to me.
So gratitude clearly is a big thing for you.
Yeah, and if I hadn't experienced that, it might not have been gratitude, but it's gratitude. Because when you're thankful, man, it's good. You're just always thankful. You're thankful for the moment, thankful for the interview, thank you for breathing, thank you for the sky, thank you for the rain. It's a good practice.
What's your idea of misery?
My idea of misery is not seeing all the blessings you have, you know? You know, not seeing life's gift every day. That's miserable.
Do you have heroes? Do you have a male hero?
strangely enough, maybe my father, who's probably not my hero too, but probably my dad. He gave me a lot when I was very young. I left home when I was 12 and I never saw him again. And he saved me from a lot of stuff because I hit the streets pretty hard. I was in Oakland, California. And I just feel like he gave me a lot of tools. He was an immigrant, my dad. Like, how do you deal with the police? How do you deal with, you know, they're gonna be stopping you, you're a young black male. Like, he gave me the tools to deal with authority and police and making the right decisions and not putting needles in your arms. He was very, very powerful in my life as a youngster. So he's probably my hero, and then probably not my hero too, so.
What about a female hero?
I couldn't say my mom, that'd be too easy.
Well, you could.
You could say mom, Nina Simone, my grandmother. It's a cross between those three.
What's your favorite place on earth?
Right here with you. My favorite place on earth is, it's gotta be Oakland, California, the Bay Area.
Yeah.
Favorite place in the world.
If you're on a desert island, you can only have one thing. What is it?
I want it all, shit. That's my problem, is that I want it all. So I don't know, I'd probably want, you know, women and water.
Women and water. You're gonna be all right. Yeah. If you ran the world, what's the first thing you'd do?
Tell people to stop judging each other and hating each other and being assholes to each other. And get rid of party lines and predatory capitalists and just misery.
If you had a superpower, what would it be?
Slap people without them knowing. Some people need it, man. Come on, you know. Like, what was that? That was the hand.
Well, that's like the you know, people who say, I want to be invisible, because you could pull all sorts of shit.
I'd get boring after a while. Being invisible.
All right, so just being able to throw a slap without anybody. Yeah. Are you a morning person or a night owl?
Night owl.
Is it easier to write a love song or a revenge song?
I hear that I'm terrible at writing love songs. Revenge. Revenge is probably, strangely enough, the guy that's so happy. Revenge is probably easier for me.
You're a complex man, obviously.
I'm fucked up. But I'm aware of it, and I'm working on it.
Yeah,
I
you're
think
working
that's
on
what
it.
I'm very aware of it, yeah, man, and that's...
You can get away with murder. Yeah, I'm really fucked up, but I'm working on it.
I'm working on it, yeah. So cut me some slack, right? I'm working on it every day, shit.
Digital or analog?
Analog.
Any particular reason?
Come on, just listen. This is like analog. It's beautiful, it has shape, and it's not perfect, and it's fat and warm, and
Do you have any before show or recording ritual?
I throw up before shows. I'm terrified to get on stage.
Is there anything you've seen backstage you wish you hadn't?
Yeah, I was doing it, you know, so yeah, there you go.
Yeah?
Answer that.
Okay.
That shouldn't have happened. That shouldn't have happened, man.
What's the title of the movie of your life?
I'm working on it.
Okay. Cut me some slack.
Cut me some slack. I'm fucked up. I'm working on it. Cut me some slack.
What's your current state of mind?
I'm in LA. I feel it's a strange feeling being in LA. It's a very strange place. I mean, all the greatest things in the world happened to me in LA, and then all the worst things in the world happened to me in LA. So, you know, I'm going with it. I'm going with the flow. I want to go eat some sushi because you can get good sushi in LA.
You can.
There's not that much good sushi in the Bay Area. Sorry, Bay Area. I love you for everything else, but not that much good sushi.
It's ironic when you consider you're right next to the ocean.
Yeah, there's just something about LA. There's some good sushi spots.
Yeah.
So I'm looking forward to that. And I'm happy.
Cool.
I think I'm happy. Life is good. You know what I mean? We're here. I feel pretty good.
Thanks, man.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For having me.
Thanks. Appreciate it.